Welcome everyone. Today we will learn about two Australian duck species that often puzzle bird watchers, the chestnut teal and the grey teal. Identifying these ducks can be challenging, but it's also rewarding. I'm Rob Nicholson, your guide to Australian bird identification. This video is aimed at bird watching beginners, visitors to Australia, and the bird curious. Let's get started. The first species we'll be working with today is the chestnut teal. The male in breeding plumage is the easiest to recognise. It has a shiny green head, grey bill, chestnut flanks, a white thigh patch, brown back, and a black tail. Next, we have the female plumage, which looks very different. Their plumage is mottled grey-brown with a darkish grey gradient that lightens brown down to the neck. Males also molt into this plumage during the non-breeding season. On to the next species, the grey teal. Luckily, the males don't enter breeding plumage, so both males and females of this species look the same all year round. Wait a minute, doesn't this species look the same as the female chestnut teal we just saw? Yes, that is true. In fact, the grey teal was a cryptic species for a very long time. Naturalists formally named the chestnut teal back in 1838. At that time, they mistook grey teals for chestnuts in non-breeding plumage. Over time, naturalists started noticing groups of these teals had vastly different habitat preferences, and it seemed odd that many female teals seemed okay with mating with males in non-breeding plumage. It took 30 years after naming the chestnut teal for the grey to be formally recognised as its own species. I'll show you shortly how to differentiate chestnut and grey teals. Let's take a step back though. We first need to be able to distinguish teals from other Australian ducks that look similar. A distinguishing feature of the teals is that adults have red eyes. We often can't get close enough to see the eye colour, so let's see how the plumage differs. The breeding plumage of the chestnut teal male is hard to mix up with other native species. However, the introduced mallard has a similar plumage with a shiny green head, yellow bill, chestnut breast, and white neck ring. The rest of the body is primarily grey and white from the neck down. In the chestnut breeding male, the chestnut plumage extends down the body and it doesn't have a neck ring and the bill is grey. Given the plumage of the grey teal, chestnut non-breeding males and females look almost the same, I'll be referring to them collectively throughout the rest of this video as dull teals. An easy way to separate dull teals from other ducks is that dull teals have close to uniform coloured plumage when you see them from afar. Here are the two most commonly reported ducks that could cause some confusion with teal identification. The Pacific Black is easy to rule out because of its strong facial stripes. And the Australian Wood Duck female kind of looks similar to a grey teal, but it is much more patterned, definitely not uniform. So what makes these species a teal and not some other duck? The term teal is generally assigned to smaller ducks. This holds true for grey and chestnut teals, as they are more than 30% smaller than the average Australian duck species. Interestingly, the word teal as a colour originates from the Eurasian or common teal. The breeding male of this species has such a distinctive blue-green coloration that people started using the word teal to refer to this colour combination. Where can we find Australian teal? Grey teals are common and widespread across Australia. They generally stick to freshwater habitats. Chestnut teals are abundant in southern Australia and are commonly found near the coast. Unlike grey teal, they are indifferent to brackish and salty water. Now, identification would be easy if both species stuck to their preferred habitat. Unfortunately, their distributions overlap and both species often mix in flocks. So chestnut teal often venture inland and grey teals occasionally visit coastal areas. Because of this, we shouldn't assume species based purely on location. Well, if I see a group of dull-coloured teals, and I can't see a shiny head of a chestnut male within that group, can I assume that these are all grey teal? Unfortunately not. that distinctive green head of the chestnut only lasts during the breeding season. Outside the breeding season, males will be in dull plumage just like the females. The breeding season for the chestnut teal is generally June to November, but significant weather events and climate change can throw this off. This means that we can't say things like, "I can't see any green heads and it's August, therefore these all must be grey." Evolution led grey teals down a different path. They don't have a regular breeding season. They can breed throughout the year, providing suitable conditions. For grey teal, it's impractical to have breeding plumage due to this erratic breeding season. Transitioning into breeding plumage can take up to 4 weeks. So if the grey teal ended up doing this, any opportunity for good weather or food abundance would surely be diminished by the time that the male got his breeding plumage sorted. So, how do we determine what species that dull-coloured teal is? Unfortunately, the distinction between the two is not strong. The primary method is to look at the area around the neck and face. This area is white in grey teal, whereas in chestnut teal, this same area is brownish white. There are two other methods to support the primary ID method. The first is by looking at the overall plumage. Chestnut teals are browner than grey teals. The second is by looking at the colour distinction between the head cap and the throat. In the grey, there is a noticeable distinction between these. But in the chestnut, a distinction is there, but it's less prominent. Both of these methods are unreliable because in the field, we don't always have perfect lighting or both species standing or swimming next to each other for comparison. Because of this, I recommend sticking with the first technique of looking for the white neck. And I have one final technique that can be used as a shortcut. Understanding teal behaviour can help with identification. Chestnut teal pair up while foraging, whereas grey teal partners tend to roam free. This means if you see a chestnut teal male in breeding plumage alongside a dull teal, that dull teal is almost always the female chestnut. Onto the calls. Females have a laughing quack, and males have a cute peep. Both species' calls are practically the same. Let's have a listen to the grey teal's call. Here's a quick quiz to test out your teal identification skills. An easy one first. We see the chestnut breeding male, and as mentioned earlier, that would be the partner female. What do you think this next one is? This one's a grey. Notice the white throat. This next one does look a lot darker than the previous one. This one's a chestnut. And a final tricky one. This one's a chestnut. Notice the lack of whiteness in the throat. Don't worry if you didn't get all these. These are some of the trickiest Australian birds to identify. With practice, you'll be identifying teals in no time. Let's go over the key points that we've covered. First, we determine how to tell teals apart from other duck species. The red eye and almost uniform coloured plumage with no distinct patterning. Next, we saw the shiny green head of the breeding male chestnut teal. Lastly, for the dull teals, a white throat area indicates a grey teal, and a brown throat indicates a chestnut teal female or a non-breeding male. There you have it. Next time you see ducks on the water, be sure to check out whether you have any chestnut or grey teals. If you found this video helpful, give it a like. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe. Let me know if there's any bird species or topics you'd like covered in a future video. Happy bird watching, and catch you next time.